Hey guys, what's going on? And today I have Cheat3’s level 5 puzzle out of 10 with me. And I want to see, can I solve it? It's, Cheat3’s puzzle's really good. And some of the hardest Lego puzzle boxes, I'd have to say, they've made. So, okay, we are going to be putting a timer on the clock of 15 minutes. As you can see, it says 15 minutes. Let's hop right in. 3, 2, 1, and go. All right, timer's ticking, and I don't want to waste time. Okay, so what do we want to do? Sometimes they put tools on the top. That's pretty good. I noticed that they have this little button right here, and that slides with it. I'm assuming it has to do something with sliding tiles. And speaking of key concepts, you really took it to the next level with their Lego geometry. Like, you really have to take a good look at where things could possibly be. So, you can see the timer back there. I'm just gonna focus on solving this puzzle. Okay. So, now, is there, I don't know, what's the objective? I believe the objective for this one is to just get the 1x2 green tile out, honey piece. So we can do that. So I noticed that there's a little hole in there. I think. What? So I'm coming out the other side. Yes. So you can see putting that through that hole. It's the star. Cool. Now what does that do? I've noticed that there's also a hole right here. It doesn't really do anything, but I'm seeing how this tile could have been a locking mechanism because you can't get past it without it. So we can just put this back in. And sometimes talking to yourself is good when getting through hard puzzles. And, you know, just kind of think, you know, what's happening on the inside of the puzzle. So that's good. Okay. I need to beat 15 minutes. 12 minutes and 30 seconds now. Running low on time. I don't know if you can see, but that is a clear inside transparent 1x2 brick, meaning that there's no center tube in the center of the brick, meaning that if I push, yes, that's what we want. Is there a little switchy? Ooh, that can go in, but I don't want to do that just because we may need it, and I don't want to have it locked in. Okay. There's this little hole right here. What does that do? I heard something move. Don't know what it is. Oh! Okay, now it's not locked in anymore. That's good. That's good. I don't want it. That's actually a really good helper. So, all we got are these little two tiles out. And I was thinking, if we put this in the hole, there we go. We have another tile. Okay. So, I'm still kind of, you know, just playing around with this. So what I'm assuming is, you know, there's on one of these pieces, I'm assuming it's the bigger one right here, there's just tile everywhere, and then just they left one stud for a 1x2 tile so that they could create sliding movement like so. You gotta kind of line it up in order to turn it. Almost 10 minutes 20 seconds. Yikes. Okay, we need to solve this soon. So, really hard to tell, but I'll push this in. Actually, we'll do this one, it'll be easier. You can somewhat tell where the tiles are. Just simply because there's just a little little indent on the bottom. So that kind of separates, right here, separates so you know what's the difference between a plate and a tile. Harder to catch when they take this Lego geometry to the next level. But put that, take that out. This red one right here, that's a tile. Because it has that extra bottom layer that's kind of indented, I knew that was a tile. So I believe we just need to get that tile out. And that tile's green. That one's green. So, you know, there's a couple. That's just a green brick. But there are a couple possibilities of what we're trying to take out. Okay. I think 15 minutes is good enough time. So I'm still struggling on the sliding movement right here. I mean, yes, it's sliding movement, but I think we're done with it now. I don't think there's anything else we need. But then again, I recognized that's a tile. We need to get that out. And we still have 8 minutes left. That's not that bad. But I don't know. Or there's some surprise move waiting for me. It's kind of what I'm concerned about. And also, this piece is pretty wiggly. Like, when we put this into there, it prevented it from going all the way in. I think that was crucial. I'm just gonna think about it. Nothing there. We got to examine the top. Was anything waiting for us? Oh, sliding tiles. Oh, I think that was just the tile that's making this move. Yeah, that's an accident. Everything else, yeah. Well, we'll keep that in mind. I mean, that would be a sneaky move. Then again, sliding tiles is one of our more common concepts that you could put in a puzzle. Ugh, I'm struggling. Okay. Whoop, I just pushed that out. Dang it. So, come on. Just coming up, 6 minutes. Ugh, the time is ticking. I thought we were on a pretty good roll, but what if we still have a lot to do? Not looking good. Because when I was looking at 8 minutes, I was like, we'll probably get something, but I don't know. I mean, this is level 5. I mean, you'd think after 15 minutes, we'd be at least almost done. We should be done. I mean, I don't even think this is that hard of a puzzle. Wait. Something I realized here. Obviously, if we push the tile into here, this can go all the way through. But there's a... So, if you saw key concept number 6, we talked about with the locking mechanism, how on top of the button, when you have that one stud that pokes out, instead of using just a 1x1 tile, you should use a 1x2 tile as a resistor. That will help create a more good lock for the button. If you saw that video, you'll know what I mean. But just by looking on the inside, maybe you're hard to see on camera, but looking at the inside, there is a 1x2 tile. So if we could potentially slide that tile from the inside using our tool right here, that might help. And we gotta do it quick. So I'm going to attempt to slide that tile, because the entire time I think we're locking it. So let's get that going. There we go. I pushed it in and I've slid the tile. Okay. Yes. Yes. That's what I'm talking about. That is what I'm talking about. We're making progress with these little tiles that are poking out. And I don't think that's the money piece. I think that's the money piece. But we do need to shake that pink piece out somehow. And we gotta do it soon. I mean, we're running a little tight on time. I'm just trying to take that pink piece out, and there we go. I've taken that out, and now I think it's okay to push that in. Okay, I think we're done. What? You're right. There's the green. There, that's the money one. It's hard to see when the 100, but that is it. Woo! Okay. Closing in at 2 minutes and 32 seconds left. I say our timing wasn't bad. We still had a little time to spare. But I do want to take a look at the mechanism of just the entire thing, in case you didn't know. But also, I like looking at mechanisms. I mean, I did build this up. Okay. So that one there. Okay, so yeah, you can see how there's plates around, and like I said, yep, that tile kind of stays. So, once again, with the resistors, this is what I was talking about. They put a 1x2 tile here instead of just a regular plate. So, from the inside, I was sliding that over so I could push that through this hole, as you can see. And that got this one out. First, we'll slide that money back in. And then this one was pretty straightforward. I mean, it was just these two were locking this one in. And so pretty much the hole kind of, there's a little indent, which is where we slid this through to get that one open. And then that transparent brick I was talking about, right here, you can see it slides. That was on the inside. So that's how we got this tile. And yeah, pretty good puzzle. I say our timing wasn't bad at all. I say we did pretty good job. So I think that is all we have for this video today. And looks like we will see you in the next one. Bye.